Hey, sweet pea, it's your wife-to-be. I just want to thank you for loving me unconditionally and helping me become the woman I am today so we can go ahead and grow together and combine us, make us a family, a bigger family, of course. And I love you, and I can't wait to see you at the altar.
Okay, hey, baby, how you doing? If you're seeing this right now, we already got married. I'm just thankful for you choosing me. I know it took a while for us to come together, but we here now. And I'm just ready to spend the rest of my life with you and just live life to its fullest. Grow old together, travel the world, and raise beautiful kids. I love you. What's going on, man?
Welcome to the family.
Hey, appreciate it.
Your dad is still kicking ass, man.
Hey, I know you were raised right. I know your heritage.
I'm so nervous now.
Appreciate it. And
the hour is at hand. Congratulations, the hour is at hand.
Oh yeah, we here in Niagara there. Ain't no turning back.
No.
Real slow, real slow. Little baby.
Why am I not here in the wedding?
Thank y'all, that was beautiful. Very much. Ring the bell, ring the bell. Hey, so we're gonna song
was
supposed to walk
out
there?
I don't even think it was a song, because remember last time we was already up there.
Okay. We just gonna walk out and just post up.
I guess.
Oh. Congratulations.
Appreciate that.
What day is it? What a role that. Hey, they know these two are going to do the role for the what's the role like? Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
There you go. Joyous occasion. I want to start out by just apologizing for the slight delay, but we're going to emphasize the union more so than the ceremony. So everybody that's here, thank you very much, and we definitely appreciate your patience. I looked up to the sky this morning as a friend of mine called me, and he said, hey man, I gotta make some changes because of the rain. But I said to him, in Jesus' name, there's no rain. So we're having a pretty good turnout this evening. You agree? I think the sun has settled a little bit. It's not as hot as it was. We've been out here laboring all day. So it's rather comforting. Don't you agree?
Yes.
Amen. I am Pops. I am Morgan's dad. it has taken everything in me to really hold it together. It really is. But the most important thing about standing here right now is the blessing associated with raising someone that they've come to a point in their lives that someone choose them as a wife. That is a very happy moment for my wife and I. So can we just applaud that? The Bible says, two or three in my name, I'm in the midst. I feel so much love here. It's immeasurable. There's that lump. I'm suppressing. I can't thank you all enough for being here. I can't thank Brian enough. Story. I think they were about ninth grade and Morgan had a basketball game. And after the game, Morgan walked up just to talk to her mom and myself because we always talked about her performances and stuff. And this little guy was in tow. And I saw him. She came up, sat between us, and we talked about basketball, but he sat about 10 feet away. But she did be courteous and say, "Daddy, that's Brian." He sticks his head down and waves. I say, "Is that your little boyfriend?" "No!" I mean, some things go, you don't have to say, right? You just don't have to say certain things. So, make a long story short, life is non-coincidental. And if we believe it and trust God, there is no coincidence. You believe? Do you believe?
Yes.
With certainty, do you believe that life is non-coincidental?
Yes.
Amen. So if we trust God, and He is forever doing more than we could ever imagine, here we are. That's every situation when it comes to retuning the mind, the body, and the soul. Nothing is of coincidence. I can't thank Brian enough for being that person. I can't thank God enough for having him be that person, that this day is possible. Thanks, everybody.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. 'Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose.
Get to the bottom and see it, man.
'Cause I give you all of me.
Tell him again, baby.
And you give me all.
What's the name? What's the name?
Millie.
Millie, tell him again.
Here comes the bride.
That's right, baby. Thank you, Millie.
Good job, baby girl.
Hey.
Everyone, please be seated. Marriage is a sacred institution, the basis of human society, and should be held in high honor among all men and women. We are assembled here in the presence of God to join man and this woman in holy marriage. This holy marriage is instituted of God, regulated by His commandments, and blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us therefore reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare of humankind. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity. We thank you for these two people that have decided to become one. Father God, we ask that you know when they don't know, love when they don't know how to, and continue when they don't see a road ahead of them. Father God, we thank you and ask this in your name, Jesus. In your son, Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Our Savior has declared that a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife. By his apostles, he has instructed those who enter into this relationship to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear each other's infirmities and weakness, to conform each other in sickness, trouble, sorrow, in honesty, and industry, to provide each other and for their household, in temporal things, to pray for and encourage each other in things pertaining to God, and to live together as heirs of His grace. Who give this woman to be married?
We do.
For as much as these two persons have come to this place of worship to be made one in holy relationship of marriage, it understood that neither of them, nor present, nor others present, or aware of any just reasons why the contracting parties may not be lawfully joined. I charge you both before God and Father and the searcher of all hearts that if either of you know any reason why you may not lawfully be joined together in harmony with the will of God, their union is not blessed of them. Let us bow our heads. Our Father, whose presence brings happiness to every condition, and whose favor sweetens every relation in life. We pray thee to be present and favor these two persons that they may be truly joined in the honorable estate of marriage. As they have brought together by providence, sanctify them by the Spirit and grant them your full understanding of their new relationship. Enrich their lives by thy grace, that they may enjoy the comfort, undergo the cares, endure the trials, and perform duties of life together as Christian people under thy guidance and protection through our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Brian, son. I love you, man.
Later, Father.
Brian, do you solemnly agree before God and those witnesses to take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife, to love, respect her, honor, and cherish her in health and in sickness, in prosperity and in adversity, and leaving all others to keep yourself only unto her, so as long as you may live?
I do.
He do. Morgan. I love you, baby.
Love you too,
baby.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Morgan, do you, in a like manner, solemnly agree, solemnly agree to receive this man as your lawful wedded husband, to love and respect him, and to live with him in faith, in tenderness, in health, and in sickness, in prosperity, and in adversity, and leaving all others to keep yourself only unto him, so as long as you both shall live?
I do.
She do too. Dig it. I need for you to repeat after me, Brian.
All right.
I, Brian.
I, Brian.
Looking at her.
I, Brian.
Take you, Morgan. To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And I do promise and covenant.
And I do promise and covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Morgan?
Yes.
Repeat after Dad.
Love you too.
I'm Morgan Jennings.
I'm Morgan Jennings.
Take you, Brian. To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And I do promise and covenant.
And I do promise and covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
And in sickness and in health.
And in sickness and health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I believe you have a ring, sir. May this beautiful token and pledge symbolize the purity and endlessness of your love. Place it on her finger. This ring I give to you in token and in pledge of our constant faith and abiding love. Morgan, you have a ring? May this beautiful token and pledge symbolize the purity and endlessness of your love. This ring I give to you in token and pledge and of our constant faith and abiding love. So Let us pray again. Heavenly Father, we have heard from these two persons that acceptance of the solemn and significant vows of marriage, do thou grant upon them grace and courage, love and loyalty, consistency and faith to maintain these vows to the end of the way. May this new home radiate the sunshine of their love, and may every heart that comes in contact with this home and its several relationships be enriched and ennobled. Through Christ our Lord, who shares in this sacred institution, amen.
Amen.
By the authority committed unto me as a minister of the gospel, I declare Morgan and Brian are now husband and wife according to the ordinance of God and the law of this great state.
Kiss me.
You may kiss the bride.
God has joined these two together in marriage. Let no man seek to dissolve this union. May we look to the Father of all of us for his blessings at this benediction. Lord, bless you, keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you both and be gracious to you both. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give peace. The Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and forever. Amen.
Thanks, Jelani, very much. Right now, we're gonna do the Unity Cross. Mom, I'm gonna need your help, please. Thank you. At this time, Morgan and Brian will assemble the Unity Cross, which is a beautiful structure that will display in their home to remind them of the covenant they are making today. In Genesis chapter 1, we read that God created man in his own image. That means that he created man bold, strong, to be a leader, to be a protector of his wife and his family.
You're gonna do cross for you.
The outer form of the Unity Cross represents the strength, leadership, and protection of the man. The book of Ephesians reminds a husband to live to love their wives as Christ loved the church, totally and completely giving himself to her. As well, Genesis 2:20-23 tells us that the woman was taken from man. The bride's piece of the Unity Cross represents the beauty and the many capabilities of the woman. Designed with intricate, beautiful detail, and is placed inside the protection of the groom's cross, completing the structure and representing the two becoming one. To complete the structure, representing the couple's covenant, we are placing three pegs to hold it together. These pegs represent the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, showing God's place in this covenant and the security of the completeness that only the Heavenly Father can give.
Clutch.
The scripture tells us that a three-strand cord is not easily broken. That's Ecclesiastes 4:12. Matthew 19:5-6 says, "For this reason a man will leave his father and his mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate." Round of applause. Take notice, we placed communion in your chairs. And at this particular time, we would like to do just that, to bless this occasion. For this is the Lord's Supper, his day, his house, his table, and his people. It is the Lord's table, which the church it is the Lord's table, which the church as his bride prepares for him. In the observance of the Lord's Supper, we have the perfect blending of physical things and the vision of God. The bread and the wine are physical. At the institution of the Lord's Supper in the upper room in Jerusalem, they were simply the leftovers from the meal. But whenever and wherever men and women of spiritual discernment gather at the table of his presence and observe this Christian ordinance, something more than bread, something more than wine is there. It is the custom of the Christian church, following an apostolic example, to observe the Lord's Supper on this day of the week. Let a man examine himself, and so eat of the bread and drink of the cup. This is the attitude in which we should approach this memorial feast. For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he gave thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Eat your bread. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also, the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is a new covenant of my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Take your wine. "For as often as you eat this bread and drink of this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again." Amen.
Amen. Appreciate it, my brother. We too play out.
At this time, if you'd like to just hang out here, it'd be fine, or you could just go on the inside.
Cocktail hour.
Cocktail hour.
All right, baby.
Congratulations, Brian. Congratulations,
buddy.
I'm proud of you.
We love y'all.
Yeah,
I love y'all.
I just want to give a quick shout out to my boy, Brian. I love you, man. Do the right thing.
Hello, Cousin Morgan, and now Cousin Brian. This is Cousin Stephanie. I wish you nothing but the best, and may God continue to bless you all from this day forward.
A wonderful time tonight over here, Brian and Morgan's wedding. Congratulations, y'all. Shout out to Morgan. Y'all have a good one, man. Peace and blessings.
Morgan, love you, sweetheart. I remember you little girl out there playing in the backyard. I am so happy and so proud that you're happily married, and I hope you many blessings for the rest of your life, sweetheart, you and Brian. In Jesus' name.
Definitely, man. Y'all brother here, been knowing y'all since ninth grade. So definitely happy to be here, man. Wish y'all the best of luck. And y'all know I'm here for the journey, so much love.
To the happy couple. God bless. Love you all. Robin.
Love, peace, and happy.
Congratulations. Long, happy marriage.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Hi, Missy Poole and my new nephew. I want to wish you many years of happiness and joy. Embrace love. Just as God embraced the church. He loves you. You love each other. And that's just how it is.
Second of all, Major E, if you guys are ever in an argument, make sure that you have a safe word. Land that safe word, shout it out, walk away from the situation for 30 minutes, go back, and then resolve whatever issue it is, because at the end of the day, you guys have each other, and there's nothing more important.
Congratulations to Keith and Morgan, man. Y'all do the doggone thing. You know, representing the Emperor Lamar Garrett clan. You know, we here representing. Appreciate y'all inviting us.
Sure.
That's how we roll the Newt. Yo, appreciate it. Congratulations.
If you need anything, let us know. We're more than happy. Me and my wife been in the game, man, for 18 years. We're more than happy to holler at you. If you got any problems. All right.
Hey, CB, man. I'm really proud of you, bro. I'm really, really proud of you. Congratulations to you and Morgan for getting married. Your union, bro, it's a great event. I'm really proud. I'm happy to be a part of this event. And I love you, man. Much love to my cousin Morgan, my cousin Brian. We all want to be family today. Congratulations.
Wish you all the best. And just remember to keep God first and love each other. Take care.
Best wishes to Brian, my cousin Morgan. Best of luck always.
The lobster's about to get started. It's a beautiful day. You're about to have plenty more beautiful days after this. Make the most of it. Don't give up on any opportunity. And make each other happy. Stay true.
Mending and coming together is one. Thank you for the friends and family that have traveled from wherever they travel from. And just thank you for the fellowship that we are about to have. Thank you for the parents who have raised these wonderful children. And God, thank you. Just thank you for today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't pin you.
But first we have Ashley.
Yeah.
plan.
Jay, catch it, Jay.
Two. Three. Let's go.
Shoot it, Jay.
Slow down.
I'm sorry. Baby, walk, baby, walk, baby, walk, baby, walk, baby, walk.